Up until now, I never really thought about it, but I think my lab is not the safest place. I mean, here we got sharp things, hot things, cables that can strangle you, and much, much more. And yes, I'm only saying this because I now have a newborn around, who will soon learn how to open doors and get himself in trouble. To prevent this, I could of course lock my door with a key, but I can already see myself forgetting where I put it. No, I want something way more convenient and awesome. And since I got this fingerprint reader that was featured in a previous AliExpress hidden gem video, I thought, why not use that as an identification method to get into my lab? And that is exactly what I will try to pull off in this video. And I already know that this is not gonna be easy, because there are no standardized components for such a job. But maybe it'll work out, so that you can make your own and get some more privacy as well in your room. So let's get started. This video is sponsored by Upper Story and their game Spintronics, which in a nutshell lets you build electrical circuits with mechanical components. I think this way it is much easier to understand how voltage and current behaves in a circuit, because you can actually see them. The speed of the chain, for example, is the current, and the pull of the chain is the voltage. Combine this principle with an enticing story where you learn about the basics of electronics, and you got yourself an awesome learning experience that I can highly recommend. Or go crazy and just make the circuits you feel like. And don't worry, as soon as inductors and transistors get introduced, the challenges step up their game quite a bit. If that sounds like your cup of tea, then click the link below and use code GREATSCOTS to get 10% off your total order. Now to start off this project, I firstly had a look at commercial solutions. And I gotta say, I was a bit disappointed. You see, all these products get mounted as door handles, onto the part of the door that is obviously moving. The problem with that is that you cannot power these locks with the help of an outlet. You have to use a battery. And since I'm not a mechanical genius that can come up with a contraption that would work as a lock without requiring lots of electrical power, I will probably have to stick to relays or solenoids, and these require quite a bit of power. That means a battery is out of the question for me, since I would have to recharge it all the time. And thus, my project has to sit next to the moving part of the door, and needs to somehow work with the receptacles for the handle and key lock. And I gotta admit, finding a solution for this problem took me some time. But I think I found one in the form of this electric lock that you can easily get from the internet. Now normally this lip of the lock is fixed into place, and thus when the handle thingy pushes into it, the door cannot be opened. But when you apply 10 to 24 volts DC or AC to its terminals, then you can see that the integrated relay draws around 260 milliamps and thus moves a pin out of the way so that the lip can now get pushed away and the door can get opened. So in theory, this solution sounds like a good idea. Only problem is that such an electric lock is designed to be used with house doors and not inner doors, and thus this thing didn't fit into the metal holder of the door and also not in the wood behind it. And trust me, I searched through the entire internet to find a fitting electric lock, but they simply do not exist. So what I did instead was firstly altering the metal holder by enlarging the rectangle cutouts, creating two mounting holes for the electric lock, and finally removing a small section next to the cutout so that ultimately the lock fit nicely and worked like a charm. And in case you're wondering how I can move the lip without electrical power, let me tell you that there is a small mechanical release system integrated. Okay, next it was time to alter the door frame to make the lock fit inside. And that was pretty easy to do with an oscillating multi-tool. It just took a bit of time. And with that step complete, I was super happy to find out that the lock not only fit beautifully, but it also worked like intended. Meaning you can pull to open the door, and if the lock is closed, there is no way you can get inside. Now to do a proper electrical test though, I next had to drill a 3mm hole through the complete door frame, through which two wires fit, which I then secured to the electric lock that obviously once again got mounted to the door frame. And as you can see, the lock still works when using electrical energy, meaning it was time to move on to the control circuit, which I built onto a small piece of perf board with the help of a 5V regulator, Arduino microcontroller, a MOSFET, and ultimately the fingerprint reader. The first code I then uploaded was directly from the Adafruit example library, and with it, it was super easy to register my right thumb fingerprint for the identification process. And after then editing a second Adafruit example sketch so that it turns on the MOSFET switch for 3 seconds as soon as the correct fingerprint got detected, uploading that and adding a 12V LED strip for testing to the circuits, it was clear that everything works just fine like intended. But after doing the same exact test with the electric lock, which by the way also worked just fine, I started to realize that I'm not the biggest fan of the fingerprint reader design. Mostly because the blue light will probably annoy me when it is dark. Thankfully though, I had another more inconspicuous looking fingerprint reader laying around, whose integrated LED ring I could not only easily use in the code to show if the identification process was successful or not, but I could also utilize its wake-up wire that gets put low when someone touches the reader, in order to relieve the microcontroller of some processing work. So yeah, this will be my final setup, whose code and schematic you can like always download from the video description. And as you would expect, everything still works perfectly fine. But at this point, I had to make it all look a bit nicer. Which is why next, I designed a fitting enclosure that I then 3D printed with the help of some wood-colored filaments. So as soon as everything was cleaned up and fit nicely together, I drilled holes for the enclosure into the wall next to the door frame, mounted it there with some screws, and then put the electronic circuit inside the enclosure along with a 12V 1A power supply to obviously power everything. And after then closing everything up and adding mains voltage power, I gotta say that I was very happy with the result so far. But some of you might also say right now that this is my stupidest project so far. Because guess what, you can still open the door with the handle even when the electric lock is not turned on, making it useless. Thankfully though, I was able to fix this problem more or less easily with this doorknob kit, which required me to firstly pop off the cover from the old handles. After then removing some screws, I was able to pull off the outer handle as well as this rectangle piece of metal, which I replaced with this other one onto which the doorknob got screwed on. And after then reinstalling the screws from the beginning and pushing on the covers, it seems like this modification was successful. Because you can no longer open the door from the outside with the knob. You will always have to use the fingerprint system. So the last thing for me to do at this point was improving the power situation. And unfortunately for me, the closest outlet was around 2 meters away. And this is the outlet I always use for vacuuming. So I did what every professional electrician would do, adding a second outlet next to it. This process was not really hard, but definitely took some time. And in the end, it was sadly also pointless. Because as soon as the outlet was done, and I started laying out the required cable ducts, I was told that they look unappealing, and I should come up with another solution. So I guess I will have to do that soon in maybe another video. But so far, I hope you still enjoyed this project and maybe it inspired you to make something like this on your own. If so, consider supporting me through Patreon to keep the show going. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!